Give the Browns, they had no choice. He put them in a situation they had no choice. This was the only option. There was no other option. There was no other talking to. There was no option other than this. Skip, I get it. You get frustrated and you're like, hey, you wouldn't say this to my face. But when you threaten violence, you threaten to kill somebody. Really, bro? I mean, is that you let someone on Twitter talk you out of a half a million or $1 million job?
Yep.
Because you missed a tackle and the guy ran for a touchdown. And so what? Guess what? You missed a tackle, the guy got a touchdown, you still gonna collect a check today. That's the way you gotta look at it. That's the only way you can stay positive, Skip, sometimes in situations like this. Mm-hmm. Because that's the only bright light. And say, you know what? I missed this tackle, but it won't happen again.
Yep.
But it just goes to show you, Skip, normally when a guy reacts like this, there's something bigger going on within the four walls of that locker room.
That is true. Yeah.
This is not just all of a sudden you just let, because somebody said you were a bum on Twitter. Or you missed a tackle. It's bigger than that.
Yeah.
Don't let anybody else fool you. I spent 14 years in the locker room, and I understand when guys get to a point where they want to do this, they want to fight, they want to lash out, it's more than what's going on in the, on the field of play. Now, they wanted Freddie because I guess over the last half, Skip, he called a great game.
Last year,
Freddie Kitchen, who the he was a running back coach when they cleaned house and fired Hugh Jackson and Todd Haley. Mm-hmm. He was elevated to the offensive coordinator. Greg Williams was the defensive coordinator, but he had already also been a head coach. He got elevated to head coach. Well, obviously, when the quarterback plays well, Baker signed off on this. Mm-hmm. If Baker says, no, I want Greg Williams to be my coach, Greg Williams has been the head coach of the Cleveland Browns. Mm. But, Skip, this is when a guy will go on Twitter, and you can, this is a grown man, so it's kind of hard to tell a grown man what to do. But normally, if you have respect for your head coach, the threat of what could possibly happen if you were to do something like this. See, in New England, you don't have this because they know Coach Belichick will get your ass up out of there quickly. It ain't no, well, I can talk to the GM or I can.
Yeah.
Ain't no circumventing Coach Belichick's authority. You act a fool, he shows you the door. It's as simple as that. That's how it was with Mike. Mike Shanahan, my coach, you act a fool, you got up out of there. But one way to do things, Skip. Mm. This was
How about your first coach, Dan Reeves?
Oh, man.
Now, you know
Reeves. Oh, man.
Look here.
No.
Ultimate
Dan Reeves was old school. He played for Coach Tom Landry. He was the offensive coordinator under Coach Landry. Yep. And so you didn't, Coach Reeves didn't boot BS.
Nope.
But this is the way it has to be. These kids, Skip, they're getting out of control with this. Mm-hmm. You know, it's Twitter and this IG, they want clicks and likes, and they're getting out of pocket with a lot of this stuff they tweet.
I mean, social media to me has its pros and cons, and it depends on how you use it.
Yes.
You know, it's to your avail. But the message that I think a lot of these guys try to convey, you know, clearly in this situation, his message was clear, and it was just totally out of character. I couldn't believe what I was reading. But to put yourself in that situation when you have an opportunity of a lifetime that you'll look back, you know, 2 months from now and say, what did I just do? I blew my opportunity.
2 hours.
I worked hard my entire life to let my little social media campaign or whatever I was trying to get across affect everything that I worked hard for. You got to watch your language. You got to watch your work. This is football. This is the game that you're supposed to love. Even if you come off the field on Sundays after a loss and you got beat over the top 6 times and you, got ran over 5 times?
Yep.
Okay, just get better next week. Who cares or so? Yeah, somebody's going to talk about you and they're going to criticize you, and rightfully so. You make it right.
Before you go, Skip, how many people on Twitter, any social media platform, that will tweet an athlete or celebrity that would trade places in a New York minute with that celebrity or that athlete?
I mean,
so that's what you got to look at.
Yeah.
I'm looking at it like this.
I think you're right.
I guarantee you, I'm trash. I just gave up a 75-yard touchdown. But I guarantee you, you would trade places with me today for that opportunity to get run over on an NFL field or to be an actor in a movie. The movie might have been terrible, but you trade places with me.
To put a uniform on.
For sure.
Jermaine Whitehead was on his 4th team in 5 years. He was undrafted out of Auburn, and he was the starting free safety for the Cleveland Browns, who used to be, just a couple of months ago, the IT team in the National Football League, right? The chic pick to win the division and make big noise in the playoffs.
I picked him.
You picked him. Baker Mayfield, did you? Okay. Baker Mayfield, kind of an early pick to be MVP, right?
Caesar said the heavy money was coming in
right?
on him to be MVP.
Okay, and it's come to this. And Jermaine Whitehead was expendable because I don't think he's a great player, obviously, yeah. and wasn't really doing much for them.
Right.
So John, I assume it was John Dorsey's call to right. the GM to say, right. I got to send some message back yep. to the locker room. Yep. This yeah. will not be tolerated.
Yeah. Yep.
But Freddie Kitchens has tried to come across as the ultimate players coach, defending the players at every turn. You be you. Just be you. Yeah.
Okay.
And all that matters is what we say to each other. Those are the only opinions that matter.
Okay.
And all of a sudden, you've got a team that has just spun completely out of control because it's a bunch of solo acts trying to be a football yeah. team. And you guys know football only works when you're like that. Right?
Absolutely.
Yes. Right?
Yes.
Because your success, when you guys got on rolls, the team was together.
Right.
It's the ultimate unity sport to me, and this is the ultimate me team.
Yep.
And it starts with Odell, me. It goes to Jarvis. It goes to Baker. Just weird behavior. I'm going to say it again on Baker yesterday. And again, he shoulders much of the blame here, even though I think he's been a victim of what the sort of the culture that Freddie has started.
Right.
Freddie is completely in over his head, and yet Baker's acting weirder and weirder by the week because he shows up with a full beard mustache yesterday, and for kickoff, he shaves a big part of it but leaves the goatee and the mustache.
Yeah, he pulled a Bobby, remember Bobby Valentine?
Yeah,
he
yeah.
got suspended, got kicked out of the game, and then he showed back
he,
up in the dugout.
Put it on, yeah, okay. But that was fake, and this was real hair, so he shaved
this
it down
real.
This.
Well, he didn't think we recognized it.
Okay.
I showed up with a beard, Skip, okay. and I got the beard gold.
And then after the game,
his number.
But he shaved down the mustache to just a little mustache.
He got a Charlie Chaplin going yeah. on now.
He put on some bizarre oversized trench coat like, you guys won't, you don't even know who I am. Yeah, we know exactly who
you
are.
I had a coach once told me, say, son, if I let you be you, you be you get cut, I get fired. Freddie Kitchens, that's what happens. When you let the players be themselves, when
yep.
you don't have rules and regulate, and that's the thing. And I've had some coaches, Skip, great, they were great men. But they let the players do whatever. If you want to be overweight, be overweight. If you want to be late. Just play on Sunday.
No.
It doesn't work. No. It doesn't work like that.
You got to earn that right to be called a player's coach. You got to earn. You got to come in and you got to solidify your position.
Yes.
You got to be stern. You got to win football games. And you got to gain respect before you can be called the players.
Yeah, we'd be out there stretching. We'd be out there stretching and guys would still be straggling on the field.
Yeah, what is
Man,
that?
Man, when Mike got there.
Andy Reid would have never allowed us.
Man, I wish you would.
And yet Andy was seen as
he was a player's coach.
Yes.
Yeah.
Andy's
a player's
coach. Mike was a player's
coach.
But
a player's coach, but
yes.
Andy Reid?
Okay. I still believe at the end of the day, players want discipline. Players want structure.
That's true.
They like the
Skip,
structure.
Skip, I don't want to be in my seat and the coach talking and guys mm-hmm. coming in. Hell, my time is valuable, too.
Yeah.
I wanted to get a couple of extra minutes of sleep.
Yep.
But I found a way to make it on time.
I got it.
You need to make it on time, too.
So poor Jermaine Whitehead is a victim of all this culture
yes.
and a symptom of everything that's wrong.
Right.
Because
Absolutely.
He thought it was just fine to go straight to his locker and sit in the stall
yes.
and look at, they can't say this about me. Watch this. Boom, 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 boom.
In the locker room, Skip. He couldn't even wait till he get to the bus
no,
or the plane.
He
did it from the locker room.
Still in his uniform. And in the age we live in, the bad news travels so fast that the PR guy walked straight over to him, took him by the arm and said, you've got to leave here because we don't want the media to ask you about what you just tweeted.
Oh,
so in uniform, he's led out of the locker room to dress elsewhere.
That's a mess.
And he is no longer a Cleveland Brown.
That is okay. an absolute
Over
mess, unfortunately.
Somebody put him in a situation
that's so
and cost
bizarre.
Him a half a
yeah.
meal or a
that's
meal.
So bizarre
and it
to
just,
me.
it speaks to more going on in
yeah.
that locker room,
Ooh.
Which is the problem for them. Michael, good to have you.
Thank you.
As always, we're going to talk Bill Belichick next. Has he
Wait
made
a second.
A big mistake
yeah.
by turning the defense over to his son?
To his son.